But when it comes to tongues, you know, realize that there are Catholics that speak in tongues. Years ago, an individual I knew, he knew of a group of people that went to a Roman Catholic church where they spoke in tongues. And she was a linguist. And they sat in the back, but she wanted to get a little bit closer to hear what they were saying. When she got to the front, she came right back, told them, get out of here. They're praising the devil. No. When we look at the history of the Roman Catholic Church, should that really surprise us? Because of their basis being found in Babylon. A lot of their weird doctrines, so to speak, they aren't taken from the Bible as we know it. What do I mean by that? You realize that there's another group section to the Bible that is not biblical in any way, but the books are full of flaws that contradict the Bible, but it has been coupled with the Bible in years past, and some people still couple it. Actually, let me back up. Some versions of the Bible still couple it with the Bible, and that is the Apocrypha. There are weird doctrines that are unbiblical, such as praying to the dead, praying to the saints, purgatory. All that doesn't come from the Bible we hold in our hands, but it comes from the latter end, the Apocrypha, which is not part of our Bible. That's where a lot of their unbiblical or weird doctrines, as we may call it, come from. And in my notes, Sister Goodwin put down that the Roman Catholic Church is headed for spiritual disaster. But I'm going to read some a few quotes next week, because we're out of time this week, where it's not just the Roman Catholic Church that is in danger. It is the entire Christian church, whether true Christian or Christian in name only, is probably the best way I can put it, because there's a lot of people that sit in church under the name Christian that really don't live a Christian lifestyle. And the sad part is the same is true with ministers. There's a lot of people that are ministering the gospel that really aren't saved and should be on the platform to begin with. But when we look at the age in which we're living in, we can see that Christ is quickly coming back. Because, like I said, the Roman Catholic Church isn't the only church that's in trouble, because we are seeing more and more of a blending of the faiths and a pushing for the blending of the faiths. And when we read our Bible and we know what's going to come in the future, that should be a giant warning for us, because what's going to happen in the tribulation period when it comes to the church side of things? One world religion. And even within the last 2 years, we've had big name Christian leaders pushing for a one-world religion right alongside the Pope and Muslim imams, for a uniting of all faiths. The Roman Church, while it might be in danger, so is the entire Christian community because of that blending that's coming. We are going to stop here. We will talk more about the Catholic Church next week. But let us bow our heads and pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you all praise and glory for everything you've done for us and shall continue to do. We give you all praise and glory because you alone are holy, you alone are worthy. Jesus, even right now, we rebuke every attack of the enemy that should come our way. We pray that you set your angels at the four corners of the property, above and below, that no attack of the enemy may penetrate. I pray that our hearts and our minds would be in one mindset and one accord, that we may worship you in sincerity, that the Holy Ghost may have his way, moving and making himself visible as he so chooses. Anoint the song leader and the musicians as they lead us in the song should have us to sing. Anoint the pastor as he brings forth your word today. Anoint his mind and his lips to bring forth your words. Anoint our minds, anoint our hearts to receive your message today, Lord, that we fall in good soil, that we may remember it throughout the week, but even greater than that, that it would take root in our heart, that we would be even greater transformed into your very image. We ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.